I'm about to launch from the shadows like a lion on the grind coming at you. I'm a menace for the vengeance, so relentless. Hope you ready, cause I'm here to battle. Keeping me awake till the late night. Thinking about a wrong, I'ma make right. When you see me, better take flight. Venom in my veins, and I'm all out of play nice. And it's bye-bye gone to the bygones. Ain't no turning back when the fight's on. When you see the white in my eyes, better run, better hide. No surviving what I'm on.
I ain't here to play around. If I were you, I would run right now. Make your feet bang, bang on the ground. Cause I'ma hunt you down, down, down. I'ma hunt you down. I'ma hunt you down, down, down. Yeah. Cause I'ma hunt you down. I'ma hunt you down.
What is up, guys? Dashing here, bringing you episode 36 of Octane, and jumping straight into the action, as always, as we are, of course, winding down the season, coming to an end very, very soon. Only a couple of weeks left, and we are looking forward to our season finale event live from Mexico City, Mexico, Fortune, guys, which is actually going to be a two-a-night event. And the card already looking absolutely stacked. Dare I even say hot and spicy? Just like tonight's show. And you can see the lovely Aria making their way to the ring. This will be Amare Rivers in action, as he's getting ready to take on Joseph Santos. This matchup actually coming our way because of what happened last episode of Octane, where Amare Rivers assaulted Joseph Santos on the stage before his matchup with Jason Spade. Amare Rivers and Spade then brawling in the ring before being separated. Is that a word? I just made it up. Now it is. Separated by security. We all know what happened at Incarcerated Scarface's. Spade forcing Rivers to tap out via the Collar City Clutch. But unfortunately, Rivers now going to have to face the consequences for assaulting El Rato. Santos not the kind of man to be punked out like that. And I'm sure he's still feeling the effects of that Elimination Chamber match where undoubtedly, he was the MVP, man. What a performance by Joseph Santos at Incarcerated Scarfaces, but unfortunately still came up short. It was Ozone, as we know, winning the Elimination Chamber match. And, well, now he's got his championship opportunity at Fortune. He's already chosen to face Jay Young for the CMV Global Championship. But here tonight, guys, Ozone going to be going one-on-one with Jay Young's protege, the undefeated Ben Stacy. Santos, I'm sure, upset at missing out on yet another opportunity to potentially reclaim the CMV Global Championship. But here tonight, just focused on making Amare Rivers pay for taking away from him what could have been a great matchup last episode of Octane, and a big win against Jason Spade. But here tonight, guys, we've got a big main event one-on-one. It is going to be Josh Wolfe versus Blake Virtue. Non-title matchup, but a matchup that Josh Wolfe has certainly been wanting for quite a while now. Hounding Blake Virtue the last couple of months or so in that Anarchy Championship to the top rope. Santos wasting no time. Looking to put Amare Rivers away with the quickness. The lowdown hooks the leg. One. One of the fastest wins in CMV history. That would have been right there, as, of course, Isabella Almas watches from ringside. Here tonight, guys, the final two rite of passage medallions also going to be fought for. We're going to see who will join George King, Danger Cat, Brandon Ace, and Damian Killfest in that Rite of Passage Championship match at Fortune. As it will be Czar versus Troy Colt in a Falls Count Anywhere match. We'll also see Richard Gelaney of the company take on Levi Marta for the sixth and final medallion. Joseph Santos thrown out a forearm smash, goes nowhere. Mara River's gonna capitalize on a little power slam. Now a rolling neck snap also here tonight, guys. Ashley Rain back in action for the first time since Validation, where she, of course, lost her Women's World Championship to Ari Lee. Earlier this week on Shockwave, attacking Ari Lee during her matchup with Tora Troy Evans. Rain making it clear she wants her championship back before this season comes to an end. Santos back to the top rope. Another loadout. Some more big action in the women's division, guys. We're also going to have Chloe Marks one-on-one with Keo. Now, that could be a show stealer, no doubt about it, as Santos misses that springboard leg drop, but going to make up for it with a schoolboy kick right to the side of the head. And to the top rope. Once more, could it be a third loadout? No. El Rato looking for something different this time. A crossbody. Goes for the pin. Oh, but besides, oh, okay. Having a bit of trouble is Santos, but Mare Rivers denying him the win. Springboard leg drop about to hit it that time, but Rivers getting out of the way. Certainly things haven't been going the way of Adia as of late. Most certainly for Amari Rivers and incarcerated Scarfaces. But right now he's tuning up the band, guys. Looking for some sweet chin music. Hooks the leg. One, two. A two count only, though. As Rivers straight back on the attack. That standing 450 splash of his could certainly keep Santos down for the uno, the dos, but no tres. No tres for Amare Rivers. Looking to bounce back after his loss to Jason Spade, but not to be. Santos fights free, tries to throw out a kick. Great defense by Amare Rivers. And now Santos going to get thrown out of the ring rather unceremoniously. But a springboard senton. That was a rough-looking landing for Amare Rivers. Santos more than happy to take advantage, though. This is that first kick to the head. Gets him the second time, though. And that's right, guys. We've switched to water. No more Mountain Dew here. I am a water man now. Gotta be careful. Can never be too safe. My security guard's protecting me at all times after the amount of times I've been put through this very announce table. And speaking of, oh my God, Amare Rivers countering a Hurricane Rana with a power. I thought for a second he was going to drop Santos onto the announce table. Yes, of course, water and Dubby. Dubby in my water, as a matter of fact. Hey, with our special promo code, CMV23, you can save yourself 10%. Get yourself a bit of Dubby. Back into the ring, and Santos immediately catching Amare Rivers with a super kick. Didn't get all of it, but certainly got enough of it, as now he looks to finish Amare Rivers off. Could it be Splash Mountain? Yes, it could. Oh, but not sounded. Oh my God, the leg of Amare Rivers. And here comes Isabella Almas, the vixen, calling over Santos. Her beauty just simply too great to deny. A rookie mistake by El Rato. He's gonna get back into control. Oh, and there's the Florida Flatliner just like that. One, two, not just like that. Santos frustrated, even getting in Johnson's face, saying, "You sure that wasn't a three count?" Great matchup to kick off Octane. Episode 36, springboard wheelbarrow bulldog busting Amare open, making Isabella cringe, her lover bleeding. She can do to help him. Santos gonna go after the arm now. snapping it off to the side. Haven't gotten a good look at Amare's face just yet. Looks like he might be bleeding from the bridge of his nose. Grabbing him by the back of the head, gonna try and bring him into the corner. Make Santos apologize to Isabella Almas. Back elbow nicely done by Amare. Indeed, it is the bridge of his nose. And here's the power of Amare Rivers on display. Dropped out of the military press right into that standing moonsault. Power and agility working together. What is Isabella Almas doing at ringside as Amare, guys, tunes up the band? Sweet chin music. Almas throwing in a steel chair. Might not be necessary, though. Wow, come on now. Amare Rivers stealing the dub as Johnson did not see the rope right there. Santos grabbing the rope at about 2.5. Maybe he was distracted by that steel chair. Amare Rivers with a big win here tonight, no doubt about it. That's the one time you can't really blame Johnson, though. Isabella Almas threw in that steel chair, distracted him. He didn't see the rope break, but I agree. We do need new referees. Hopefully, we will get some going into the new season who actually know how to do their jobs, by and large. Coming up next here on Octane, episode 36, Mr. Money in the Bank, guys. Bloody Justice set for action against Andrew Briggs, but oh, it looks like Eybjorn has other plans in mind. Eybjorn assaulting Andrew Briggs backstage, it would appear, and looking to take his place in this matchup. Eybjorn, who has been on a tear the last couple of months, ever since joining up with the Red Fox, Reese Matthews, a part of the men's elimination chamber match at Incarcerated Scarfaces. By the way, there's Reese. He just came out of nowhere, very suddenly appearing at ringside. He's never far, though, from his client, Eybjorn, I guess. But Eybjorn, guys, a great showing in the chamber. Even managed to eliminate Anarchy champion Blake Virtue, but ended up getting taken out himself. Looks like he doesn't want this season to end, though, on a sour note. Trying to take the fight to Mr. Money in the Bank, Bloody Justice. And, well, Andrew Briggs, once again, that's not the first time that Andrew Briggs has been attacked backstage and his spot in a match taken from him. Really can't catch a break. Ugyorn just defeating Andrew Briggs last episode of Octane, but well, it seems like Ugyorn, who we actually saw training earlier this week alongside Reese Matthews, running some laps, getting that cardio in. Reese Matthews saying that's why Ugyorn lost the Elimination Chamber match, because they weren't focusing on his cardio, and that's what matters most in a match like the Elimination Chamber, saying Ugyorn has the size, he has that monstrous rampage he can go on, but he's got to work on a few things, and Reese Matthews more than happy to help him out. Looks like maybe that training paid off. Ugyorn just tearing apart Bloody Justice right now. Massive side slam, goes for the pin, only a one count. Ugyorn looking over at Reese Matthews for a moment. Bloody Justice has had the Money in the Bank briefcase since Ascendance 10. Of course, he has yet to cash it in. He did threaten to cash it in one time while Joseph Santos was CMV Global Champion, but well, we know he has until Ascendance 11 to cash it in, so he's taking his time, waiting for the perfect opportunity, but right now that's the last thing on his mind as Reese Matthews gets out of the way. Ugyorn just bombarding Bloody Justice, man, with power move after power move. Now tossing him right into the barricade. Ugyorn with murderous intent, it would seem, dropping Bloody Justice gut first onto the barricade, and then a boot right to the side of the head. Andrew Briggs has now been helped in the back after being taken out by Ugyorn. Up to a count of six. Ugyorn does not seem to care, though. Well, now he does. Get back into the ring. And gonna show off the 18-inch pythons, brother. Bloody Justice not gonna take this lion down. He's attempting to fight back, but certainly blindsided by Ugyorn here tonight. Pinfall attempt. Ugyorn hoping to just keep Bloody Justice down. I mean, what a win this would be. The knockoff, Mr. Money in the Bank. Both men going for a clothesline there, but looks like Bloody Justice got the better of Ugyorn. Now going to go for that spinning tombstone pile driver, but Ugyorn not having it. Instead, the Claymore kick connects, but Ugyorn not even going to think about going for the pin as he looks to make sure the job is done with Odin's curse. One, two, three. Not a three count. A momentary look at Ugyorn's face there. Pure shock. But back to work with a deadlift gut wrench suplex. Reese Matthews barking orders from ringside. Bloody Justice continues to try and fight back. But this has been about 95% Ugyorn, man. He is dominating Bloody Justice. Ooh, Johnson getting caught in the middle of things there. I think he'll be okay, though. Meanwhile, I don't know if Bloody Justice is going to be okay. Ugyorn just moving with purpose here tonight. Again, the season is coming to a close. Ugyorn wanting another opportunity. After failing to win the Elimination Chamber match and incarcerated Scarface, he's not going to wait for a said opportunity. Now a Boston Crab, middle of the ring, and nowhere for Bloody Justice to go. Mr. Money in the Bank could be in serious trouble here now. As Ugyorn just sits on that lower back, but Bloody Justice fights free. And the Red Fox watching from ringside, doing all he can to propel his client to the top of the food chain here in CMB to lead Ugyorn to his destiny. Tries for a clothesline out of the corner. Bloody Justice saw it coming, though. Reverse DDT down out of the knee. Bloody Justice moving a bit faster now. Has he caught that second wind? I think so. Spinning tombstone pile driver. Not going to go for the pin, though. Right into Sister's Joy. Has Ugyorn made a mistake here tonight? One, two. Bloody Justice beside himself, really thought he had the match won there. And it's been a million miles a minute. These two have just beaten the ever-living hell out of each other. Objorn trying to make a statement here tonight at the expense of Mr. Money in the Bank, but Bloody Justice is not making it easy. Dragon Scrap! And Objorn now with another Claymore kick that busts BJ open. This time goes for the pin. 1, 2! Still, the three count manages to elude Ugbjorn, who's getting pissed off now. And gonna channel that anger as he looks to hit another ring shaking, thunderous Odin's curse. 1, 2, 3, Ugbjorn picking up a great win here tonight, a win that he took. That cardio training paying off from what I saw here tonight. Objorn moving like we've never seen him move before. His destiny awaits him, and no one gonna stand in his way. It is our third matchup of the evening coming up next, my friends, and a rite of passage medallion on the line as Czar and Troy Colt prepare to face off once again, but this time in a Falls Count Anywhere match. And for the last couple of months, Czar has been on a mission, it seems, to destroy Troy Colt. It all started when Troy Colt was supposed to have a backstage interview, and Czar just out of nowhere brutally attacked him and threw him off the loading dock through a table. And since then, Czar has just continuously beaten down Troy Colt again and again and again. But Troy Colt says enough is enough. And here tonight, he's going to make Czar pay for putting him through hell these last couple of months. And add to that the fact that a rite of passage medallion is on the line here. And Troy Colt is most certainly gonna bring that A++ game. The winner of this gonna earn that medallion, gonna join George King, Danger Cat, Brandon Ace, and Damian Kiltfest, along with one other. We'll find out who later on tonight is Richard Gelini and Levi Marta battle for the sixth and final medallion. The Rite of Passage championship match to take place at Fortune, our season finale event, guys, and we learned what the main event will be at Fortune, which we now know will be a two-night event, but night two is going to be headline, guys. Ellie Quinn, Keo, Inside Hell in a Cell. Former tag team partners, former friends, turned eternal blood rivals going to collide inside their own personal hell, as Ellie Quinn said. Final confrontation between Ellie Quinn and Keo, but right now it's the final confrontation between Czar and Troy Colton. This Falls Count Anywhere match, where they ride a passage medallion on the line, and Troy Colton going right after Czar. That might be the only way you can take the fight to Czar, man. You can't play around with this boy. Troy Colton knows these two went one-on-one a few weeks ago. A great matchup, but in the end, Czar victorious. Buckle bomb going to take Colt down in the corner. Stomped an extended arm still to come here tonight. Ashley Rain back in action, one-on-one with Mina. We've also got Chloe Marks, Keo, one-on-one. And in our main event, non-title matchup, as Josh Wolf going to finally get his hands on Blake Virtue, mano a mano. Is that how you say that? I don't think so. I think it's mano a mano, but we'll go with whatever. I can't tell you how to live your life. Tries for another knee drop, but misses, and Czar trying to pounce on Troy Colt. Ball's cut anywhere. Pinfall submissions not only can happen in the ring, but ringside, in the crowd, out on the street, it doesn't matter. No count out to disqualifications either. Shot to the back of the knee. Troy Colt gonna focus on that knee, trying to take out the base of the big man. Look at this now, a sort of modified sharpshooter locked in by Colt. He might actually have Czar ready to tap, but shoulder claw of doom being applied and stomped to the bicep, because why not? And Czar looks to do what he does best. Show off that power, dropping Colt out of the military press. Now it charging me, but took a little bit too long, and Troy Colt able to prepare for it, and there's the bicycle super kick, vintage Colt right into the pin. One, two, three, wow! And just like that, Troy Colt puts away Czar. Unbelievably, I think Colt just getting lucky there, catching Czar off guard with the bicycle super kick and putting him down, not only earning himself some payback, but also earning a Rite of Passage medallion. Troy Colt gonna join the Rite of Passage championship match in Fortune. That's gotta feel so good for Troy Colt. Well, the action continues here on Octane, episode 36, as Ben Stacy, with, of course, his mentor, the CMV Global Champion, Jay Young, in his corner, preparing to meet Ozone one-on-one. We know that Ozone at Incarcerated Scarface is the man who was victorious inside of the Elimination Chamber, earning the right to challenge for the World Championship of his choosing at our season finale event, Fortune. And he wasted no time in selecting Jay Young and that Global Championship of his. So indeed it is set at Fortune, Ozone, Jay Young for the CMV Global Championship. But here tonight, Ben Stacy hoping to do a number on Ozone, set him up for a proper thrashing at the hands of Jay Young at Fortune. And Ben Stacy, guys, thus far unbeaten here in CMU. I mean, that's what happens when you get Jay Young, who was trained by Hall of Famer Dave Turner, takes all that knowledge, along with his own knowledge, for the years he's competed here in CMV, passes all of that off to Ben Stacy, who just his last matchup defeated Harvey Hastings. But will his undefeated streak remain intact here tonight? As Ozone hopes to send a message to Jay Young watching from ringside. And what a matchup it will be at Fortune 2. Entirely different styles clashing, the high-flying daredevil antics of Ozone up against the technical prowess of Jay Young. So Jay Young in the corner of the young, impressive Ben Stacy. Knife-edge chop. Good start as Stacy throws Ozone into the corner. Jay Young liking what he's seeing. Now up on the top. Oh, going for maybe a Frankensteiner, but Ozone said, uh-uh. How about a boot to the face instead, Young Gun? Whip. Gonna prompt Ozone to go for that springboard move. Oh, damn, moonsault turned into a reverse DDT and then straight to the top row. That's what I'm talking about, man. The human highlight reel. Ozone, every single match, man, delivers just something breathtaking. Almost puts away Ben Stacy right there. Now a springboard moonsault, keeping the pressure on Stacy, but now Jay Young getting involved, distracting Ozone, allowing Stacy to take control with that double boot stomp to the chest. Followed up by a ripcord forearm smash. Still to come here tonight, my friends. Up next, Ashley Rain returning to action one-on-one with Nina. And in our main event, Josh Wolf and Blake Virtue finally meet one-on-one. Non-title matchup, but Wolf's certainly been waiting to get his hands on Virtue. Straight up. Saw that tag team matchup earlier this week on Shockwave. Amber Reed and Blake Virtue knocking off Kill Your Heroes, but Wolf has been calling to get this one-on-one shot against Blake Virtue for a while now. Getting a bit cheeky, Ozone. That twisting body slash and then a knee drop to the extended arm. Another knee drop. Targeting the face of Ben Stacy. He says, no thank you. Super kick to the knee, setting Stacy up for a backflip German suplex bridge, but not trying to pin. And Jay Young again, gonna distract Ozone here, trying to get in Ozone's head, but it looks like Ben Stacy is out of it after that German suplex. The distraction not doing very much for him there. Irish whip now into the corner. Putting him up on the top rope. Ozone could potentially be setting Stacy up for that inverted Frankensteiner. Stacy trying to fight back. But Ozone's got him right where he wants him. The daredevil. Some murderous elbows to the side of the head. And the inverted Frankensteiner off the top rope. Ozone taking a big shot himself, but it might pay off. Middle of the ring, hooks the leg, but only a two count. Could just be a precious couple of seconds. Ozone took to actually make the pin, but now to the top rope, the outer layer! Middle of the ring, and all Jay Young can do is watch. One, two, three, Ozone! Handing Ben Stacy his first loss here in CMV. You see Young at ringside, devastated. He did not like seeing that. Is that what awaits Jay Young at Fortune Live from Mexico City, Mexico? It most certainly is. The question is, can Jay Young come up with an answer? A way to shut down Ozone and his daredevil antics. Ozone is coming for the CMB Global Championship. Will he leave Fortune with it? Will he finally become a world champion here in CMB? Next matchup, guys, the women's division, the return of Ashley Rain. First time she's in action since Validation, where she, of course, lost her women's world championship to the young Audie Lee, capping off an incredible first month in CMV. But Rain, earlier this week on Shockwave, assaulting Ari Lee during her matchup with Tora Troy Evans, certainly helping Evans pick up the win in that matchup. Big win for herself, but Rain making it clear that before this season comes to an end, she wants her Women's World Championship back. And that matchup has now been set at Fortune Live from Mexico City, Mexico. A rematch between Ashley Rain and Ari Lee for the Women's World Championship. We know what an absolute humdinger it was at Validation, man. One of the better matches I think we've had this entire season. So I am definitely ready, willing, and able to see the two of them get down and dirty once more. But of course, Rain, in her mind, she's not looking to have a good match. She's just looking to end the season by getting that Women's World Championship back around her waist. But here tonight, up against Mina, who certainly Probably having a few bumps and bruises. Participating in the Women's Elimination Chamber match at Incarcerated Scarfaces for the Women's Hardcore Championship. Obviously, the night not going very well for Mina, as Amber Reed is still Women's Hardcore Champion. But we know, guys, Amber Reed last week on Twitter issuing an open challenge to anyone to step up to the plate at Fortune and challenge her for the Women's Hardcore Championship. Maybe Mina looking to be the one to answer that open challenge. I'm sure there are a great many in that locker room who are hoping to do just that. Have to wait and see until the event itself, who's going to be coming down that walkway and stepping up to the history maker. She looks to go into the new season still Women's Hardcore Champion, but right now Mina, certainly knowing what an opportunity this could be to knock off someone the caliber of Ashley Rain. Turn the Tree of Woe, but doesn't last very long. Elbow to the midsection. Also still to come here tonight, my friends, Richard Gelaney, Levi Marta for the final Rite of Passage medallion. Which one of them will join George King, Danger Cat, Brandon Ace, Damian Killfest? And as we found out earlier tonight, Troy Cole in our main event. One-on-one Josh Wolf, Blake Virtue non-title matchup. Will Wolf make the most of this opportunity? He's been itching to get a one-on-one matchup against Virtue for a while now. As Mina pulls at the arm of Ashley Rain. Ari Lee, I'm sure, watching this matchup. I think Ari Lee proved to a great many in the CM Universe, many of her doubters at Incarcerated Scarface when she successfully retained the Women's World Championship against Alexia Diamond, that she is no flash in the pan. Oh, Mina! Shield your eyes, Isabella Almas, if you are potentially watching this match. The wins are not. And a kick to the buns. Doesn't stop there, does Mina? Drop right face first on a top turnbuckle. And it is all Mina right now. The former Women's Hardcore Champion in her own right. Caught by Rain with that elbow to the gut. Knife edge chop and a drop kick. You know, Rain is not happy at all about being the punching bag in this Ari Lee story. What a first month it was for Ari Lee. There's no denying that. Coming into CMV within a couple of weeks, winning the Women's Royal Rumble matchup, Mob Violence, going on to defeat Ashley Rain at Validation for the Women's World Championship. Rain ain't having that. She ain't gonna be the stepping stone for Ari Lee. Bring the fairy tale to an end at Fortune. Right now, Mina is certainly giving her a tough fight. Kick to the back of the head, now to the second rope. Mina, wait in position as Rain gets to her feet. Hurricane Rana! Rain dazed and confused. Mina potentially going for the Mina Plex, but a forearm to the back of the head, gonna take Mina down, and Ashley Rain with the helicopter spin, slap the back of the head, adding insult to injury. Vintage Ashley Rain. Stomping on Mina's hand. Another round. She Rain with a little smirk on her face. She enjoys this. Oh my god, man. She's going for a broken hand here. Ashley Rain mercilessly stomping on Mina's hand, and now gonna go for that brain buster to put her down for the count. One, two. Mina is one tough cookie. Rain realizing that, but she's got a little something else for Mina. Getting to her feet, unaware that Rain is stalking her. Sunny side down. Good night, uno, dos, tres. Ashley Rain more than ready, it would seem, to get her Women's World Championship back That opportunity she will have at Fortune. It's the rematch, Rain Lee, for the Women's World Championship. Will the fairy tale come to an end at the hands of Rain? Will Ari Lee finish the season strong by proving that validation was no fluke? Into our tertiary main event we go. Octane episode 36. This might end up being one of the shortest episodes of Octane ever. Although you never know. We've got two more amazing matches to go after this. Chloe Marquillo one-on-one. And in the main event, Josh Wolf Blake Virtue one-on-one. But first, the sixth and final rite of passage medallion on the line, as the juggernaut of the company, Richard Gelaney, prepares to take on Levi Marta. Neither Gelaney or Marta are going to join George King, Danger Cat, Brandon Ace, Damian Kilfest, and Troy Cole in that Rite of Passage Championship match at Fortune. And you can see Gelaney joined by Shea Hawks, and I'm sure that Xander Slate would also typically be out here in the corner of Gelaney, but we all know what's transpired over the past week on Shockwave. Bob Luger making the challenge, calling out Shea Hoxton for a match at Fortune that will decide the future of Xander Slate. Luger saying, Slate, I know you're torn between your best friend and between your brother, so why don't you sit back and let us fight for you? And Slate signing the contract, guys, so it will be Shea Hoxton, Bob Luger in a ladder match at Fortune Cora Hoxton's half of the Unified World Tag Team Championship. That means whomever wins will go into the new season partnering with Xander Slate as the Unified World Tag Team Champions of CMV, essentially gaining custody of Xander Slate. And here's a man, and I use that word very lightly, who has not had the best of times since returning to CMV at the mob violence event. After many, many, many years away, it was a shock to see Levi Marta enter the men's Royal Rumble match when he was just about immediately eliminated, and since then has not been able to pick up a win, guys. Something certainly different about Levi Marta, and not different in a good way. But maybe things could change for Marta here tonight with a rite of passage medallion hanging in the balance. Judging by who he's up against, though, I'm going to be completely honest and say I don't have the greatest amount of faith in Levi Marta here. And anything can happen in that squared circle. Can Levi Marta upset Richard Gelaney? Of course, it's just been tearing through fools as of late. Coming off of his legendary performance in the tug of war at Validation. Right after, Levi Marta popping him up like a rag doll, taking him down with that German suplex. Now Gelaney gonna walk Marta over to the ropes as Shea Hoxton, very pleased with the way that this matchup has started, but not pleased with the situation between he, Xander Slate, and Bob Luger. Shea Hoxton saying Slate has nothing to prove to these people. They never cared for him. Why should he care for them? That together, along with the rest of the company, they can rule CMV. But Bob Luger says, no, brother. Walk down a brighter path. Change alongside me. Be a better man. Slate just so conflicted that he's willing to step to the side and let his future be fought for. Between Hoxton and Luger at Fortune. Damn. Levi Marta sent falling down to the outside. Hoxton is very close to the action here as Marta tries to throw out a clothesline. Barely does anything to Gelaney. Oh my God. Gelaney is just manhandling Levi Marta here. Hoxton getting out of the way, giving the juggernaut some room to work. Yokosuka cutter. Stomp to the knee. I don't think Marta has landed a single punch in this matchup so far. Uranagi, Jesus Christ. Gelaney has just become unhinged since joining the company. It's better than we have ever seen him before. Headbutt back in Gelaney away. Up to a count of eight as Gelaney now has Marta up against the barricade. Oh my God! European uppercut. Now at the count of nine, Hoxton continuing to only observe as Gelaney gets back into the ring and beats his chest like the absolute gorilla that he is. Guys, I don't think Marta's getting back up. This might be a count out win. Gelaney doesn't want that though. Gelaney doesn't want no count out win. He's coming to collect. Onto a back suplex. Marta lands it though. There we go. Finally a kick to the gut. Oh, that's all Marta's going to get though. Gelaney is continuously pushing him back, stopping Marta from grappling with him. Capture suplex shades of the great Ice Cold Savage. Now again, Marta gets back out of the ring. Resetting the count. He ain't done with Levi Marta. Drops down on into a reverse DDT. Back up to a count of three as Marta does his best to just stay alive. Gelaney resetting the count once more before throwing Levi Marta back into the squared circle. Remember, this is for a rite of passage medallion. Hoxton hooting and hollering at ringside. Gelaney. going for a double forearm smash, but instead gets a headbutt between the shoulder blades. Now that looks painful. Martin with some fight left in him. Grabbing Jelani by that beard. Just a big old punch to the gut. Look at the jaw, spins him around. Squeezing away on the traps of Richard Jelani. Potentially putting Jelani to sleep. This could be Levi Martin's opportunity. Headbutt. And Hoxton now looking a bit worried at ringside as he paces back and forth. Levi Marta earned his first victory since returning to CMV here tonight. Jelani play around with him a little bit too long. Another punch to the midsection. Irish whip now into the corner. Slow, cautious approach. Marta with some battering elbows to the side of the head, but just like that, Jelani with a choke slam. Marta back up, but runs into the double forearm smash, and again, now the Oklahoma Stampede. A roar let out by Richard Jelani as he marks his territory. Hooks the leg, one, two. Marta making Jelani think, but not for very long. Tries to go low, Levi Marta ready for him. Chop. Looking for maybe a power slam at Levi Marta with the knee to the midsection. Just can't get enough of Jelani's beard in this match. It is a very nice beard. Credit where it's due. Just giving Richard Jelani a good old-fashioned walloping in the corner. That's why you don't sleep on Levi Marta. Things haven't been going so well for him. Sure, that's true. But it's Levi Marta we're talking about. Former United States champion, former World Tag Team champion, and going for a running power slam. Hooks the leg, hang on a second. One, two. A second away from earning that rite of passage medallion. Levi Marta doesn't seem finished, but Jelani gonna stop him dead in his tracks. And a 110 street slam. One, two. Jelani now getting angry. Can't say that I blame him. But now gonna try something different. Oh boy, gonna look to break Levi Marta's back. Make him handbell, baby. The camel clutch is locked in. And Levi Marta's caught. Nowhere to go. But does not give in. Best fight we've seen from Levi Marta since his return, no doubt about it, but it might be moot. No, Jelani again! Looking to put Levi Marta away, and Marta continuously targeting the midsection of Jelani throughout this match. Blows right through Jelani! Popping him up into the air. Push back though, the juggernaut. Back into the camel clutch, noses Levi Marta. Stomp to the quad, headbutt putting Jelani down. Levi Marta acting quickly while he's got the chance. A second running power slam. Hooks the leg, one, two. Listen to these fans chanting one more time. One more time, they want a third running power slam as Jelani somehow manages to kick out again. This matchup started very, very, very promising for Richard Jelani, but Levi Marta quickly making Jelani realize exactly who he's in the ring with. Another 110th street slam, and that's gotta be it. One, two, three. Richard Jelani. Very nearly though. Taken out by Levi Marta. Multiple times in this matchup, that's what Marta's been missing, man, since his return. A fight like this, even in defeat here tonight. Levi Marta looking the best that he has since coming back to CMV. But Richard Jelani, maybe learning a valuable lesson here tonight. Do not play with your food. As he earns that sixth and final medallion, and so the field is set. George King, Danger Cat, Brandon Ace, Damian Kilfest, Troy Cole, and Richard Jelani will compete at Fortune to crown a new Rite of Passage champion. Our co-main event coming up next here on Octane, episode 36, and a hell of a matchup. It has the potential to be as Chloe Marks, guys, takes on Keo. Still to come, of course, up next in our main event, Josh Wolf, Blake Virtue, one-on-one. But Chloe Marks last week with a very bold challenge to one Tora Troy Evans. Chloe Marks saying after the Elimination Chamber match, at Incarcerated Scarface, where she eliminated Tora Troy Evans, that she wasn't all that impressed. Doesn't get the hype around Tora Troy Evans. Doesn't get why she's got the spotlight on her since coming to CMV after being so easily eliminated inside of the chamber. And Chloe Marks calling out Tora Troy Evans for a one-on-one match at Fortune, saying, I'm going to prove to everyone that you ain't so big and bad. I'll certainly say this for Chloe Marks. She's got some cojones to call out the War Goddess, who has yet to respond, but certainly here tonight, Chloe Marks got to focus on the task at hand, and that task, trying to get a big win against former Women's World Champion Keo, guys, who we now know is set to partake in the main event of Night 2 at Fortune. Live from Mexico City, Mexico, she will step inside Hell in a Cell against Ellie Quinn for the final encounter. One last time. As Ellie Quinn said herself, they'll be locked inside their own personal hell, and Ellie Quinn will finally make Keo feel the same pain that she felt all those months ago at Regicide. I'm not sure Keo is still feeling the pain of being put through that flaming table at Validation, the end of the women's tug of war match. But also hoping to focus up here, hoping to get a much needed win. So much on her mind though. Easier said than done as Johnson rings that bell. Nearly calling up a tie up. Keo. Go behind gets thrown off by Chloe Marks. Knife edge chopper, more like a bitch slap. Putting Keogh up against the ropes, drop down to the outside. Keogh takes a step back. Not interested in pursuing Chloe Marks here. Allows her to get back into the ring. Chloe Marks kicks the midsection. Keogh said that she did what she did to Ellie Quinn back at Regicide for a reason. She felt like she owed Ellie Quinn. And she felt like she repaid Ellie Quinn in full. That was time for her to move on and try to reclaim the Women's World Championship. But Ellie Quinn saying, you stabbed me in the back. You broke my heart. Now I'm going to break your body inside Hell in a Cell. Oh. Well, hang on a second, guys. Just as Chloe Marks takes control. Tora Troy Evans. Oh, hang on a minute. It looks like she's here tonight to respond to Chloe's challenge in person. The War Goddess with a steel chair right over the head of the Prodigy. Tora Troy Evans not interested in responding via social media. Responds in person. Looks like she has accepted Chloe Marks' challenge with a steel chair right over the head, which Keogh attempts to capitalize on. A very weak pinfall attempt, though. Chloe Marks saying, oh boy, hang on, what did I get myself into? But attempting to fight back, that's just how tough Chloe Marks is. Even after getting hit in the goddamn head with a steel chair. By the way, Jonathan just not knowing where that steel chair came from, but throws it to the outside as these two take their fight ringside right in front of the announce table. Keogh caught with a hangman's neck breaker. Well, Chloe Marks has her answer, I guess. She's going to get her fight at Fortune. Might be going into that matchup with a bit of a headache, though. She attempts to stay above the water here at the count of four, getting back into the ring. Keogh. So much going through her mind. Gotta imagine how difficult it would be for her to stay focused in a matchup like this, but can't afford to suffer another loss, especially with Ellie Quinn watching. Keogh showing a bit of a aggression there in the corner as she stomps on the down. Chloe Marks responds with an exploder suplex. Whatever Chloe was thinking about going for there, though, Keogh says, think again. Elbow to the gut and a pendulum backbreaker. Back and forth here between these two. Again, props to Chloe Marks for even staying in the fight after getting hit in the head with a steel chair. Courtesy of Tora Troy Evans. Chloe going after the arm, trying to set up potentially one of many things. Oh, but there's the double knee facebreaker instead. Down goes Chloe Marks. One, two. Chloe Marks not staying down. Frustrated is Keogh. Going for the Tanahashi clothesline. And will that be what it takes to keep Marks down? One, two. No, it will not. Chloe Marks showing some serious fight here in this matchup. But now that she knows she's got a date with Tora Troy Evans at Fortune, doesn't want to give Tora the satisfaction of having costed her this match. Off the top goes for something. Not too sure what. Misses it completely, though. Keogh still out on her feet. Lucky for Marks. Russian legs into a Fujiwara armbar. Fujiwara armbar applied by the Prodigy. Gets out of it, this Keogh. Into the head scissors. Great escape by the former Women's World Champion. Now these two just sizing each other up for a moment. Wrestling takedown, helicopter spin. Keogh getting a bit cheeky with Chloe Marks here. Slap to the back of the head. That kick to the back seems to have only pissed Chloe Marks off. Her toughness personified in this matchup. Rolling five, it's Kerry Senton. Right into the pin. One, two. Chloe looking off into the distance, hands on her head. Frustrated is she, but doesn't stop here. Hook to the jaw, caught by Keo, kick to the gut, caught by Chloe, counters the counter. With a kick to the head, stunning Marks, just long enough. Keo with an Irish whip. Now down to the apron and a drop kick down to the outside. Chloe Marks nearly landing on that very same steel chair Tora Troy Evans used to hit her over the head with. Now Keo's got the arm at ringside, snapping it off to the side. Keo already with wounds of war. Every Quinn has done to her over the last couple of months, but certainly going to be suffering more, and not just physically but mentally as well, when they step inside Hell in a Cell at Fortune, back into the ring. But Keo going to catch Chloe Marks. Off guard, couple of clotheslines, counters the kick, sweeps her off her feet. Keo with a woo, letting these fans know she's still going. A desperate pin, one, two. A desperate pin does not get the win. Argues this Keo, but only for a moment, but that's all the time Chloe Marks needs. Kick to the head, into a senton. Kick to the head, Keo back up. Chloe by the hair, another double knee face breaker. Stopped though by Chloe, into an air raid siren. Hooks the leg, one, two. Not enough to put Keo away. Now Chloe's not frustrated, she's pissed as these fans show their appreciation back into the Fujiwara armbar. The Fujiwara armbar locked in again by Chloe Marks. But once more, Keo hanging in there with whatever she might have left. Unable to escape, Chloe Marks deciding to instead pick her back up, walloping her. Discus clothesline. The prodigy of CMB rolling now. Grabbing Keo by the head, kick to the midsection. Giving Keo that opportunity. Half Nelson suplex, stopped by Marks. Irish whip into the corner we go. Full steam ahead. Body splash. We've seen that before from Chloe. Right into the crucifix driver. And there it is. One, two, three. Chloe Marks picking up one of the bigger wins of her CMB career here tonight. What a victory for the prodigy. And even after getting hit in the head with a steel chair by Tora Troy Evans, decided to answer Chloe's challenge in person, but Chloe Marks showing Tora with this win here, you don't scare me, and it ain't gonna be so easy to put me down. It is main event time here on Octane, episode 36, my fine feathered friends, as Josh Wolf going to get the opportunity to finally put hands on Blake Virtue one-on-one. Matchup that Wolf has been looking for quite a while now, and although the championship isn't on the line, I don't think Wolf really cares. He just wants the chance to rip Virtue apart at this point, especially after what happened earlier this week on Shockwave with Amber Reed and Blake Virtue knocking off Kill Your Heroes in tag team action. Well, there is the Anarchy champion. This all started between these two a couple months ago, and Wolf was talking some shit saying that Blake Virtue does not deserve to hold that Anarchy championship because all he really cares about is the global championship. Now, Virtue saying, yes, I do care about the global championship. I do want to become global champion again, but that doesn't mean I don't care about this Anarchy championship. And anytime you want to step up and try and take this title from me, you're more than welcome. But again, here tonight, the championship isn't on the line. Although this, if you ask me, a must-win situation for Wolf. Especially if he does want a shot at that Anarchy championship before this season comes to an end. Things not going the way of Wolf or Virtue inside of the Elimination Chamber back at Incarcerated Scarfaces. And Wolf was upset because he never even got to put hands on Virtue in that match, because as soon as he entered the match, Virtue was eliminated by Ugbjorn. Certainly got a taste of Virtue in that tag team matchup on Shockwave, but this is what Wolf's been waiting for. Still having to wear that protective mask thanks to Virtue's good friend Amber Reed breaking his nose back at Mob Violence. The season is coming to a close in just a couple of weeks, my friends. Fortune awaiting us live from Mexico City, Mexico. A two-night event. What a show it will be to cap off an amazing season as we prepare to go into a brand new season and a bright future. The return, of course, of NGW announced. The beloved developmental show making its return in the new season. That, of course, a show that Blake Virtue has a lot of history with. Came up in NGW, former NGW World Heavyweight Champion. I'm sure he's elated to see it back. But the only thing Wolf will be elated about is leaving Blake Virtue a broken body here tonight. So here we go, our main event non-title matchup, Blake Virtue and Josh Wolf one-on-one, a must-win situation for Wolf, not only with all the losses he's been taking lately, but especially wants to get that shot, that opportunity to take the Anarchy Championship away from Blake Virtue before this season reaches its end. Backbreaker into the Russian leg sweep. Virtue coming back at him with the sickle. Too much though. Virtue out onto the apron, pulling him back through the ropes, all tied up now, and Wolf has him fully exposed. Forearms to the back into a double knee back stabber. Now some brutal knees. We all know Blake Virtue to be the proverbial knee man here in CMV, maybe the most brutal knees the entire CMV roster, perhaps rivaled only by Amber Reed. Knee aficionado getting a taste of his own medicine there at the hands of Wolf. Now bring him into the corner, making him kiss the top turnbuckle, trying to rip off that arm of Josh Wolf. I'm gonna put him up on the top rope, forearms through the ribs, and Virtue taking his time as he sets up what else but a knee to the gut, and to send Wolf tumbling all the way down to the outside. hurt you. He dropped to the extended arm. You guys do not want to miss Fortune. A two-night event to end the season. We've already got some amazing matchups announced. Of course, it will be Ellie Quinn, Keo, inside Hell in a Cell. The Rite of Passage Championship match to take place. We now know who all six competitors will be. George King, Danger Cat, Brandon Ace, Damian Kilfest, Troy Colt, and Richard Gelaney. We know that Ozo will challenge Jay Young for the CMV Global Championship. We know that Shea Hoxton and Bob Luger will battle in a ladder match for custody of Xander Slate and a whole lot more. This fight taken back into the ring at the behest of Wolf. Forearm to the middle of the back. Oh, we're gonna roll the dice! Wolf kicking it up a notch now as he looks for a kick to the side of the head or a punch. Birch, we're able to see it coming. Not able to see that knee coming though, and a kick to the knee, leading into a DDT. Hooks the leg. Wolf would take great pleasure in putting down Virtue here tonight, but only a two count. Not finished. Wolf never finished. Always on the hunt as he... Whoa! What the hell? I'm not too sure what happened there. Well, these two continuing to brawl. Knife edge chop. Oh, Wolf! Well, it looks like Wolf has had enough. Looks like Wolf says, forget about it. Forget about you. Wolf's looking to leave this match. Wolf's walking out of here, but Virtue walking right into a trap. A clever trap by Josh Wolf. And now he's going to get back into the ring. Just making sure to reset the count. Wolf had no intention of walking out of this match. But Blake Virtue playing right into his hands there. I thought Bloody Justice was about to come out here for a second or something when the lights went off. Just a little malfunction. Oh, and now Virtue busted wide open. Josh Wolf firmly in the driver's seat as he sends Virtue back into the ring. Has Virtue just served himself up on a silver platter, guys? I think perhaps. As Wolf now looks for the vertebraker, but Virtue was ready for it. And the Anarchy Champion now telling Wolf to protect your neck. Hooks the leg. One, two. But Virtue with blood trickling down his face, shocked the fact that he could not put Virtue away there. Frustrated, I'm sure, in himself, falling for Wolf's little ploy. Wolf now gonna pull Virtue into a triangle choke, trying to squeeze even more blood out of Virtue's head here. Oh, Virtue trapped and unable to escape, or maybe I'm wrong. The best bout machine getting out of it. Stuck in that triangle choke for quite an amount of time, though. Kick to the midsection. Virtue with a bang! Basta floating over into the pin, middle of the ring, and Virtue put Wolf away here and dashes. Aspirations of getting a shot at the Anarchy Championship, no. Knee drop to the protective mask. Not doing a very good job protecting Wolf there. And now Virtue with a rear naked choke, saying, you want to play that game? I got you, Wolf. Now it's Wolf who, in an instant, nowhere to go. In trouble of being put to sleep here at the hands of the Anarchy Champion, but Wolf able to break free. Elbow to the wound, and again, more blood spurting out of Virtue's face. He's with a bay, though. Oh, recoil! The recoil busting Wolf open. One, two! But Wolf kicks out. Virtue stumped at this point. He doesn't know what to think. Oh, does he have another one? Though he might have another one. Wolf's not going to let him hit it, though. Yeah, like I said, the protective mask not doing a very good job. Wolf has continuously gotten busted open throughout his last few matches. Wolf gonna endure the pain as he goes for the vertebraker! Dropping Virtue on his neck! Hooks the leg! One, two, three! Wolf does it! Wolf putting away Blake Virtue here tonight. And that was a must-win situation for Wolf. It may have just gotten himself that shot at the Anarchy Championship. Even with the perpetual broken nose, Josh Wolf scoring a massive dub here tonight with that vertebraker of his. Look at that, man. He's bleeding bloody out of that mask. But victorious he stands. And now he's coming for Blake Virtue's Anarchy Championship.